In this video, we are going to analyze the relation between the linear angle and solid angle. But before directly going into relation, first we'll try to understand what exactly the solid angle means. Well, the definition of solid angle is, it is a three-dimensional angle subtended by any object at a certain point in a three-dimensional space. Now let us demonstrate what I'm saying here. If suppose I make a cone from this page here. Now, if you can clearly see that there is some angle subtended by it. Well, linear angle is nothing but the angle between the two rays, lines. But here, this is a three-dimensional angle which is getting subtended by this cone. If I want to go by a definition, then I'll consider an object which is a disc and it is a cross-section area of this cone. Then that disc, whichever angle will subtend at its vertex, will be the angle subtended by the cone, and it is nothing but a solid angle. Now we have to calculate this, and to calculate, I'll have to first check that how mathematically it will look like. Now let's say that this is a cone is having a surface area S1 and this surface area S2. Say it is at a distance of R1, and from here it is at a distance of R2. Now the solid angle, which is denoted by omega, is S1 by R1 square, which is same as S2 by R2 square. This is how it is defined. Now according to this definition, if I want to find the solid angle of this sphere, then that solid angle is going to be total area, which will be 4 pi R square divided by R square. And hence it turns out to be 4 pi. It means the complete sphere sustains an angle of 4 pi steradian as a solid angle at the center. Now it will subtend the same angle anywhere inside the sphere. Similarly, if I consider a circle and if I go for the linear angle, this is theta, this is L, this is R, then theta is going to be L by R. If I consider this complete length, then that theta will be 2 pi r upon r, and hence theta will be 2 pi radian. It means the 2 pi radian is the angle subtended by the circle, and 4 pi steradian, it is denoted by sr and this is by rad. So 4 pi steradian is the angle subtended by the sphere as a solid angle. Now we want to find a relation between the linear angle and solid angle. So I am considering a sphere. To save our time, I have drawn the figure here only. Now consider the two radii which are subtending the angle of 2 theta. And what I want to do is I want to find the solid angle for the region between these two radii. Now what will be that region between these two radii? So if I consider from here, this is consider a ring, and above that ring, this is a dome-like structure. So, when I want to find a solid angle, I'll have to consider the area of this dome-like structure. And then that area upon R square will be solid angle. Now, well, how I will get that area? So, I can consider that this dome-like structure is made up of rings of different radii with small thicknesses. Considering that, if I consider this small elemental ring, which is making an angle of alpha, and this thickness is at an angle of d alpha. In that case, the radius of the ring will be r sine alpha, and this small thickness is going to be r d alpha. Now, what will be the small elemental area? Well, that small elemental area is going to be 2 pi r sine alpha into r d alpha. So therefore, if I want to find a total area, I'll have to integrate it. Now from where to where you will do the integration? Here 2 pi r square will be constant, sine alpha d alpha. Now for the limit of integration, you just see carefully that this dome is made up of the rings of different thickness and different radii. It is of same thickness but of different radii. Now, if I consider the ring at the topmost point, it is almost having a radius of 0 and the angle is 0. And when it goes to this point, it will be having the angle of theta. So naturally, when I consider that this dome-like structure, it is made up of the rings of the same thickness with different radii, such that the angle with respect to vertical goes from 0 to theta. And hence, your integration at this point will be 0 to theta. So this will be 2 pi r square integration of sine alpha d alpha. Well, it is minus cos alpha going from 0 to theta. Naturally, this will be 2 pi r square minus cos theta minus of minus cos 0. So it will be 2 pi r square 1 minus cos theta. And how much it is? This is the total area. Now, what will be the solid angle for it? Well, the solid angle is going to be this area upon r square. So it is going to be 2 pi into 1 minus cos theta. And hence, this is the relation between the solid angle and the half of the linear angle. This angle is 2 theta. I'm taking theta, means it is the half of the linear angle. And this particular is getting effectively used in the chapter electrostatics. So I hope this complete will help you anywhere you will need a relation between the solid angle and linear angle.